Hello there and welcome. I bet you can already tell what's going on. It's grass and even animated grass wiggling in the wind nicely, almost hypnotic. Right, so it's a geometry node setup. You can get it for a small price on my Gumroad, or you can get it for free within the Baked Blender Pro Suite. Right, that's a free asset library that contains models, materials, geometry node setups, particle systems for free. And that's where you can find this as well for free, right? So you have two options. Both will be linked below. Right, so how does this work? I'm going to assume that you get this for the free, right? Because, well, who doesn't like free stuff, okay? So what we're going to do is just click this away. And then we basically have the Baked Universe Asset Library, right? That is the add-on where this will be free in, right? So you will be able to drag and drop this onto whatever you want. You can drag this onto a sphere. You can drag this onto, well, obviously a ground. It all works nicely, okay? So it's drag and drop grass. It's very fast because it's all instant, right? I try to get this very performance, low performance, I guess. So what we can do now is just tweak all of the settings, right? I can imagine you want grass where you want grass to be, right? Maybe not your entire ground face. So what you can do is just use a weight paint to control where you want it, right? Obviously, we now have to weight paint some stuff on there, but you can just weight paint the grass where you want it to be, right? So you can switch between that whenever you like, okay? Very easy. Just have the weight paint group be the same as your actual weight paint vertex group, okay? Now, let me just use that. It's going to be more... It's going to be easier for my computer, I guess, by doing this. So now we have some settings we can change, and it starts with the basic noise stuff, right? So where the grass is going to be, where it's not going to be, the noise scale, crank this down, crank that up, whatever. We've got the position of that noise as well, right? So if I crank this up, you can see the position of that noise is going to change. It's basically the W of the noise input, right? And now we also have the contrast of the noise, right? So that's going to define your blacks and your whites, right? The contrast, so where the grass is going to end and where it's going to start. You can have that to be a very hard line. If I crank this all the way up, right, you can see those empty spots are now very, it's a very hard cut from grass to no grass. And we can crank this down. It's going to be a smoother kind of interaction, right? So that depends on what you're looking for. Beautiful. Now we obviously have the grass scale. Crank this up, crank this down. Depends on, well, how large you want your grass to be. The density, we can set this to 500. It's still going to be very fast because it is instance, of course. So you can use that. Now we've got the length of the grass strand. So that's going to affect the individual grass strands. So if I crank that up, oh, that's the minimum grass length. That's my bad. That's basically where it's going to get cut off, where there's not going to be grass. If you want that to be a minimum length, then you can just set that to a minimum length, right? Which basically means all your grass is going to be just a little bit larger. It depends on what you're looking for. All right, so I'm going to set this to like 0.5. And now we have the actual grass strand length. I just skipped that. So we can just increase that and it's going to make all the grass longer. For example, if you're somewhere in a jungle where there are snakes and alligators hiding in stuff and spiders, places that I avoid in my life, then you can basically just crank this up if you want longer grass, you want weeds, whatever you're looking for. Crank up that grass. You can even use this, for example, for underwater scenes, for like weeds and stuff. What is it called? Seaweed. And you can, for example, just decrease the clump spread and you'll get more seaweed kind of stuff. All right, so beautiful. Now I'm going to crank this up a little bit again, decrease the length, right? This is all very, very, very easy to change, okay? Right, what else do we have? We've got the grass thickness, of course. We can make very thick grass. It basically makes it look like cabbages or something like that. Or leaves, I'm not sure, but you know, feel free to play around with it. Now, everything that comes with this is going to be made by me. All right, you see those textures on the grass, light and dark streaks, they are all made by me as well. So anything in here you can use completely for whatever you want, like commercially, whatever, anything you want, okay? So we've got more stuff, of course. We've got the grass strand resolution. Be careful with that. It's going to increase the performance, of course, right? If I set this to 16, we're also going to see that we get more kind of, what is it called? Like the noise in the grass strands, right? So there's that at the bottom, the grass, noise scale. I may move that up a little bit. So, but we can change that. We can decrease the strength. So it's going to be straighter. That's going to be completely up to you. Okay. I usually just leave this at 8. Okay. What else? The clump density. And now this is a little bit different than the grass density. If I set this to 100, let's say 50, we will be able to see more of what this does, right? So we have individual strands of grass, we have clumps of grass, and then we have the scattering of grass, right? So if I decrease this all the way, you can see that this basically consists of grass clumps, right? And the clump density is basically going to be how much grass there's going to be in each of these clumps. Okay, so if I increase this, you can see there's going to be more grass in each clump. And you can decrease this as well. So that's basically going to depend on how you want your density of the grass to be scattered, for example, right? So we can just set the clump density very low to like 10, and then just crank up the grass density to like 1,000. It's going to do, well, the same thing, but you will have a little bit less clumpy grass, I guess, right? So that's going to be completely up to you, okay? I'm pressing Ctrl Z a few times here. And now we come to the clump noise scale. So we also have some clumping noise going on. So if we increase the strength there, you can see that our clump of grasses are going to be a little bit more random, right? So with the noise scale, with the noise strength as well. And that's just going to make your grass a bit more random if you're looking for that kind of stuff, okay? Next up, we got the clump spread, something I find quite important. Because, well, it allows us to spread it out more and get it more together as well, right? So that's why we can make, for example, seaweed or whatever out of this. But we can also very largely increase this, which is just going to make our grass more random and more chaotic. So that is up to you. And the splitting is something fun as well, right? So that is going to make the grass go out more from the base, right? So if I up this, you can see that it's going to be going out more at those tops, all right? And you can even make them go in if you'd like that as well, right? I'm not sure why, but you can make it happen. The roundness is going to do pretty much the same, okay? Now we've got the noise scale of the grass. I just showed you that. Now comes the fun part, right? I'm going to add more grass for this, and I'm actually going to use a weight paint map of the group. My weight paint is gone for some reason. Let me get that back. There we go. Beautiful. Right, so let me just crank up the scale of the grass a little bit, the length as well, because I like long grass in the wind. And what I can do now is just check the add wind and animate button. Right away you can see that the grass is doing something weird. Not weird, just blowing in the wind. So if I now play this animation, you can see my grass is now waving in the wind, and I'm actually going to just turn that off. And we now have a lot of settings that we can tweak for the wind animation as well. There are two settings. We've got high performance wind settings and detailed wind settings. I recommend sticking to the high performance wind, so not checking this button, unless you really need high detail wind grass, I guess. But then just decrease the density first before you enable that, okay? So we can just now increase the wind strength, for example, basically going to mean your grass is flatter. I'm going to rotate this for a sec so we can see it better from the side view. All right, there we go. So we have got wind strength that is basically going to push your grass more down, right? So if I set this to 3, our grass is going to be almost at the ground. 5 is going to mean they're almost going through the ground, so don't go too crazy on that. But, you know, we can set this quite high. And so now we've got the wind strength in two directions, X and Y, basically allows you to, well, tweak where the wind is blowing your grass pretty much, right? So you can see it's changing how the grass looks pretty much. Now we've got the speed of the wind, right? So that's basically going to mean how stormy it's going to be as well. Okay, so if we increase this, our wind is just going to have a larger frequency, right? So you can see it's now looking way more stormy, right, than it was before with a lower speed. Okay, so that's up to you. The noise scale of the wind, right? So that's basically going to mean where the wind is going to affect the grass, the scale of that. So we can just up this and it's going to basically, well, be a little bit more chaotic, for example, right? For stormy days, perfect. Beautiful, beautiful. The rotation already showed you that we've got those settings up for you. You can use it for whatever. All right, so now let me show you the final step, and I'm going to crank down the density because this is a little bit tougher for your computer to handle. If we enable this high performance wind or detail, right, you can see that each strand is now affected by the wind individually, which means everything is realized. All instances are realized now, but it is more realistic. It really is. It just will curl your grass a bit more, right? And that is basically just going to affect your performance as well, right? So that is up to you which one you need the most. Okay, now of course you have the same settings here. I'm not going to go through all of them. You've got the rotation of the detailed wind, the strength, the speed, right, the frequency of that wind, and you've got the axis, so where it's going to rotate around, and the noise scale of course as well. Okay, so play around with that. I like playing around with the high performance one because it allows me to tweak all of my settings quite quickly. And finally, just let me show you this on Suzanne, right? Suzanne in the scene, hurts like that, just sitting in the background, adding a subdivision modifier of 2, and drag and drop that on Suzanne, and just crank up the noise, or sorry, the grass scale a little bit. There we go. Maybe even make the grass length a little bit larger, and then we can just animate that as well. Beautiful. If I now play this, you can see that we now have animated Suzanne hair as well, right? We can increase the strength on that. Also the wind speeds a little bit. Depends on what you're looking for. But you can see how easy it is to add animated grass on pretty much anything. Right, so if you enjoyed that, please leave a like, a comment, or subscribe. Any one of those will make me incredibly happy. Remember, you can get it both from my Gumroad for a small price and in the Baked Blender Pro Suite completely for free. Linked in the description. All right, so thank you so much and have a great day. Bye bye.